Hello everyone. At a glance, Stardew Valley seems like a really simple, straightforward game. But the reality is, it's actually really deep and really complex, with so much content that you probably don't even know most of what exists. I know I certainly don't, and I haven't seen everything there is to experience, because there's some events in this game that are so rare, they basically just don't happen. And that's exactly what we're going to be taking a look at today. What I've determined to be the rarest events in Stardew Valley, and again, some of these are so rare that even I've never seen them, and I've played for hundreds of years, put hundreds of hours into this game. Surprisingly, we're going to start off at number 1 with the meteorite. Now, the first indication that you found one is the sound of it crashing into your farm overnight as you're falling asleep, followed by some redundant text that tells you that yes, you did in fact hear something overnight. The meteorite will randomly land somewhere in your field. It will not break any buildings, it will however destroy things like crops, trees, and any of the debris that's sitting on the ground. And in order to remove it from your farm, you're going to need an upgraded pickaxe, at which point you'll be rewarded with some iridium, some geodes, and some stone. The iridium is the only thing of value that comes from a meteorite. Amazingly enough, the meteorites have a 1% chance to spawn, so that's about once in a year. And surprisingly, that actually makes them the most common occurrence on this list. 1% once a year, and they're far more common than some of the other things we're going to talk about. Coming in at number 2 on our list is a helpful little event when it does happen, and that is the crop fairy. And this fun little event, again, happens overnight. As long as you have crops in your field, you have a chance for the crop fairy to show up. What it does is randomly turns one or more of your crops into fully matured plants, that way they're ready for harvest the very next day. The amount it does seems to vary, anything from a single plant like seen here to a square of 5x5 is the biggest it's yet been reported. And if you're really lucky, this can actually happen on your very first night. I can't find any official numbers on exactly how often it happens, but the consensus seems to be about 1%. Therefore, I'm rating it a little bit rarer than the meteors because you need to actually have crops in the ground for it to show up. Whereas with the meteor, you've always got a farm field. Also, fun fact, if you grow the fairy roses in fall, it actually increases the odds of a crop fairy showing up. At number 3 on our list, we have the witch. And this event can be good or bad, depending on your outlook. Once again, this is an event that can occur overnight. About a 1% chance, again, is the consensus, rarer than the other two because you need to have either a slime hutch or a coop for it to even trigger. Once it does, the witch will turn up, cast a little spell on either of the mentioned buildings, and in the morning, well, you're in for a little surprise, which can be either good or bad. If it's your slime hutch she's been after, she turns all of your slimes black, at which point you have to restart getting all the proper colors again. Or sometimes the game bugs out and you get a weird flashing slime. That one is both blue and black somehow. Now if you're like me and are particular about the color of your slimes, simply add a wicked statue to the slime hutch and she will no longer affect the slimes. She will only get the coop. Now as we move forward on our list, we get into some of the things that are actually so rare that a lot of players will never even encounter them while they play. Most of these things from here forward I've only seen once or twice as I've been playing, and some of them not even at all. At number 4 on her list is simply some very rare dialogue from Marnie. Unfortunately, she didn't share it with us today. That's probably because the odds of her doing so are 0.01%. To put that into perspective, that is 1 in 10,000 times that you walk through that door, she's going to share some of this dialogue with you. But, fun fact, she did actually give me some of this dialogue in a stream a long time ago. If you look through enough of my videos, you can find it somewhere way back there. Now, in case you're wondering what this super secret dialogue is, well, the first phrase she can say is, "Did you bring the truffle oil?" I'm just kidding. The actual lines are, "Sigh. When the door opened, I thought it might be Lewis." And, "Lou? Oh." Now this event obviously isn't anything particularly useful, it's just amazingly rare, so if you ever get the chance to experience it for yourself, well, feel honored, because not very many people at all have ever seen it. Coming in at number 5 on our list is something even rarer than a child I actually like. And probably equally as insignificant. And that are the things we randomly see flying across the background of the shipping screen. The first one we're going to take a look at is Santa, actually the more common of the two. He apparently simply shows up on the 24th of winter, just like in real life. But once a year, obviously not that rare, right? So how about this tiny, insignificant alien flying across the top of the screen? Well, that's easy, as long as it's not the 12th or the 28th of any month and didn't rain, there's a massive 0.001% chance that it's going to show up. So for perspective, that's 1 in 100,000 days, provided it's not the 12th or 28th and didn't rain, so you might be waiting a while to see this again. Next on our list is an event that's actually so rare there's only ever really been one confirmed case of it happening. Now, think about that. There's been millions of people that have played Stardew Valley, some of them for many hundreds if not thousands of hours, one confirmed sighting. In fact, I've spent over 100 years just on this file specifically looking for this event. The event triggers overnight like many of them do. You hear a strange sound during the night. When you wake up, you find somewhere on your field this thing, the strange capsule. It simply sits here pulsing. If you mouse over it, there's something fleshy bobbing around inside the fluid. And you might notice it's pulsing not unlike a crystallarium. Then, suddenly, 3 days later, it's no longer pulsing and it looks like something has escaped. It's now known as the empty capsule. Part of the glass is shattered. And of course, no one really knows what that means or if anything happens because so few people have ever experienced this. Like I said, there's only ever been one confirmed sighting. The reason this event is so rare is that the base event itself has a 1% chance to trigger. That's not so bad, that's once a year. But once that 1% triggers, it scans your entire field. It needs to find 50 clean spaces for it to actually happen. Now the problem is, it can scan things like your pond, it can scan the edges of the field, it can scan your house. So in theory, this might not ever happen. You could play for 1,000 years with a completely clean field, you still might not see it. And that's why no one out there really has seen it. Because the odds of you having a perfectly clean field on the day it actually happens, and it to find the right spaces, pretty much non-existent. I've heard a lot of different numbers out there about how often it does actually spawn. 1 in 400 years seems to be kind of the consensus. I'm not entirely sure I agree with that, but I know I've spent well over 100 years on Nisfal looking for it, still haven't seen it. Like I said, in theory, if the scan never goes your way, you might just not see it, because out of the approximately 3,500 spaces on your farm, several hundred are automatically occupied, and if it keeps scanning even one of those spaces, it just won't happen. But that's one of the video ideas I have in the works, and I will find it eventually, I don't care how long it takes. Do you see these worms in my field? Even these can stop the capsule from spawning. If it scans these, it's not going to happen. I'm going to have to wait another 400, 500, 1,000 years. A lot of people didn't actually believe this existed because it is so rare. And a lot of pages you'll find about it actually consider it not in a game because it basically just doesn't happen. But I do know it exists, thanks to a few mods. There was a custom mod created just to help me with this process. If you'll notice in the bottom left, well, it shows what events are trying to happen. And about once a year, that 1%, you'll see it try and trigger the UFO event. It clearly says UFO event, at which point it activates its scan. Hasn't actually found the clean spaces in my field yet, but it is trying, so it is confirmed it is in the game. Now, interestingly enough, there is something that actually seems to be even rarer than a strange capsule. I'm not even sure how that's possible, but rumor is every once in a long, long while, people wake up to find this on their farm. This is a stone owl. It's very hard to find any reliable information about this anywhere on the internet or even in the game's code itself. There's only really bits and pieces, so no one's really sure if this actually exists in the game. Also, don't confuse it for the garden art stone owl. I believe you could buy it at one of the festivals. That's not the one I'm talking about. I'm considering this rarer than the strange capsule because there's just less information about it out there. At least there's some kind of confirmation about the strange capsule. With the stone owl, it's really not much. People say, yeah, they think it happened on one of their files a million years ago. No one can provide any proof of it. Even the game's code is pretty hazy on whether or not it exists at this point. My current understanding, after looking at the code, is that it can potentially spawn in the same way as a strange capsule. I'm not sure if there's any more factors involved, or maybe it's just a variable. Maybe it happens instead of the strange capsule, we're still not really sure. However, interestingly enough, after using my event mod again, we maybe have some verification that it is still in the game. As indicated here, one fine winter day, tonight's event reads owl, so I'm assuming it was trying to trigger in somewhat the same way the capsule does, but whatever factors were required just didn't happen. This seems to happen about as much as the capsule, so the base event itself probably sits about 1%, but the factors required to actually make it happen are unknown at this point. They might not even still be in the game, they might actually be the same as a strange capsule, it's just so rare that no one really has any information at this point, despite the many, many hours people have played at this game. The fact that it does show up in my event mod really gives me hope for this one. I'm really hoping to find it at some point along with a strange capsule. I really, really like the fact that they added these ultra rare things into the game. It just gives you something to look forward to and appreciate every once in a long while when you do actually encounter these. There are other rare events in the game, but as far as I could tell, these are the rarest of them. If anyone knows any more about these, please do let me know in the comments below or wherever. I want to know more about these things if you guys have ever seen them. If you have proof, that would be amazing. Or maybe there's other secrets out there that no one's even seen yet. There are a lot of Easter eggs and small things in the game that you really, really have to look for. Things like the sea monster you never see, the alien in the shipping bin, you'd never see that. I am going to continue my capsule hunt and I'll be putting a video out on that as soon as I actually find it. I'm on year 130 currently, probably going to take 400 to 500 years by everyone's theory. Might also continue the search back on stream because that's a lot of fun. keep it up with the good video ideas, whether it's Stardew Valley or other games entirely, do let me know. Always appreciated. Hope you like this one. Thank you all for watching.